Welcome back to Good Day Sinlaw. Dana Rippey joins us from the Alexandria VA to tell us more about PTSD awareness and things that we can all think about. Dana, thank you so much for joining us on the show today.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you for having us again.
Of course, of course. Well, as we wrap up the end of June, which is PTSD Awareness Month, you have some tips for us, especially going into next week with the upcoming holiday.
Right. Listening to Mayor Dupree, all I could think about was all the veterans that are going to be struggling with the weekend. While we go into it ready to celebrate, there's going to be a lot of people that are struggling with it and having, you know, reactions to it. And so I just want to go over some things that maybe the public can be aware of, and also speak to the veterans or individuals that may be suffering from PTSD as well.
Yes.
So, you know, just be aware that some of the smells, some of the sounds, some of the colors of the fireworks that they see, some of the loud pops that are going off are going to startle some people and, you know, may cause them to withdraw more, may cause them to be a little extra jumpy. So sometimes that makes people uncomfortable that aren't aware of what they're suffering from. And, you know, for the ones that are suffering from PTSD, to prepare for this, be aware of what's coming. Take some practicing of relaxation techniques, do some deep breathing, try to refocus your thoughts, you know, control your emotions, practice your grounding techniques so that when you are startled that you're able to pull that in and use that in that moment. The natural reaction for a lot of people is to avoid, is to run away, or is to stay to themselves, when that just prolongs the symptoms, that makes it stronger. So I encourage people to be aware of it, know when it's going to happen, the time and the place, and plan it, and try to be involved as much as you can so that you can take back control of your emotions and your anxiety so that you can feel better and have a better and quality of life.
So what are some things that we can do as community members to help support and really think about, you know, kind of caring for those veterans who may have issues with fireworks and everything?
Sure. You can be aware if they struggle with that, talk to them ahead of time. Ask them questions, you know, what can we do to make this easier for you? What can we do to help support you? I know this is uncomfortable for you, so how can I make it better for you? And if they do, if they are triggered in the moment, you know, remind them to breathe and remind them to focus on the here and now. Help them be in the moment. Don't touch them if you can avoid it. Don't yell at them. Speak calmly and bring them back to the present, because unfortunately sometimes they do revert back and have flashbacks and things trigger them to remember some of the horrific things that they've experienced.
If you have a veteran in your life who may have a hard time with the fireworks too, you know, and maybe you want to try to talk to them about it, help them prepare, but they are not willing to talk with you about it, what's the next best step?
Reach out for help. You know, reach out to us. We are very well trained in helping people deal with PTSD and have a better quality of life. It does work. Treatment does work. It does help. And the more you hold it in, you know, it's like putting a Band-Aid over an infection. If you don't treat the infection, it's not going to get better. So we got to get to the core of it and treat it and help you get better so that you can improve. You know, don't avoid it. I know that when you avoid it, you feel better immediately, but in the long term, it prolongs those symptoms and it makes them stronger. So reach out.
And of course, you know, even though June is PTSD Awareness Month, you know, of course, this is something we should all be aware of and learn more about, you know, throughout the whole year too.
Correct.
And so what are some things that we can do as a community to help with those efforts?
Well, there are some things that are available online. There is a National Center for PTSD, and there are so many resources on that website that can help not only us as clinicians, but family members and members that have PTSD, not just veterans, because other people suffer from PTSD as well. There are apps that are available to help. The PTSD Coach app is a really good app available. It can teach you different skills, different tools to deal with the different symptoms of PTSD, like anxiety, anger, problems with sleep. There is a family app on there. There's also, I learned looking at it this week, that there's now podcasts for PTSD Bites that some of the clinicians are putting on. So I'm excited to look into that, and hopefully it will be helpful to some of our individuals that suffer with PTSD as well.
Fantastic. If people are interested in learning more about what the Alexandria VA offers, what's the best way they can do that?
They can contact the VA. They can call us at 318-473-0010. I would be remiss if I didn't mention the crisis hotline, so 988. If you're suffering or struggling, reach out. There are trained professionals that can help get you where you need to be.
Fantastic. Well, Dana, thank you so much for joining us today.
Yes, ma'am.
And telling us about all this important information we all need to keep in mind.
Thank you so much for having us.
Of course. We'll be right back with more Good Day Sinlaw right after this break. Mm-hmm.